What's up guys, welcome to our channel Etechniz. In this video we will talk about system interrupts, high CPU usage in Windows 10. We will discuss 7 methods by which you can fix the system interrupt high CPU usage. And I want you to watch the complete video before you opt for any method given in this video. So stay tuned and watch the complete video. Before going further, if you are new to this channel, then click on subscribe button and select all on the bell notification. Give a thumbs up if you like this video and leave your feedback in the comment section. Before we start talking about the methods, how you can fix it, let's talk about what is system interrupt. As we all know, computer can just do one task at a time. They just do it very quickly, so it looks like they are multitasking. The hardware of your computer complies with the information that you have input to complete the task. And to perform the task, computer interrupts the other task. So it's really important for you to understand if you have input a command, like if I input a command to open Google Chrome, then I will wait until it's open. If you have a good configuration on your PC, like good CPU, good RAM, graphic card, if we talk about which is the best drive you should have on your PC, then we can say M.2 is the bestest best. However, if you do not have a budget to build that PC, then SSD works perfectly fine. If you have M.2, then all of the program open faster than normal hard drive opens any program, and HDD is not gonna perform as good as SSD and M.2 gonna perform. So there is a big difference between all of these three. So you can have the M.2 or SSD on your PC to perform all of the tasks faster, as on the same time if you have a good RAM and CPU and the graphic card, then all of the thing comes up faster. Now I like to mention one more thing in here. How much CPU should system interrupt use? Let me open the task manager to show you. Right now my PC is just showing me 1% of CPU usage. It usually fluctuate, but come back to the 1% or 2%. If you might be thinking 5% is too high, then I like to tell you 10% is the highest ratio. If your computer constantly on the 10%, that means you have to do something to fix your computer. Now let's talk about the method you have to use to fix the system interruption. Method 1. Restart the computer. Restarting your computer is one of the oldest way to fix any kind of problem you're facing on your computer. When you restart your computer, services which was not running on your computer start running properly. When we turn on our computer or when we wake up our computer from the sleep, that time some of the services stop working on our PC. So it's really important for you to restart your PC, to boot your PC for once. Method 2. Update drivers. Since the high CPU system interrupts problem is most of the time hardware related, but as per our suggestion, try updating the drivers. It's a simplistic and secure way that often work. Plus, it's reliable to always have driver updated. For that, click on Windows icon, type here device. As you can see device manager in here, click on it. You have to update all of the driver. You just have to click on this arrow and you'll get your drop down and do a right click on the driver and update, and click on search automatically for update driver software. It starts searching online and update your driver as well. You can click on search for update driver on Windows Update. If you click on this, then it shows you the page of Windows Update. You can click on check for update and it will list here if there is any kind of update provided by the Microsoft. Method 3. Turn off the fast startup. Fast startup task is to set your computer in a deep sleep that it looks similar as it's off. So when you restart it again, it's more like starting all the things again, and sometimes it causes problem to your hardware and software. So it's important for you to turn it off. For that, click on this Windows icon, Start, and type here Control. Click on Open. Here, click on System and Security. If you do not have any screen like this, then click on View By and select Category. Click on System and Security. Here in Power option, click on Change what the power button to. Here, click on Change setting that are currently unavailable. You'll see Turn on Fast Startup showing up in here. I'll show you the image so that you can understand properly. So what you have to do, you just have to uncheck the box of the Fast Startup. And afterwards, click on the Save Changes. And that's all you have to do to turn off the Fast Startup. Method 4. Disable Magic Packets. First, understand what is magic packets. As per the Microsoft statement, a magic packet is a standard wake-up frame that targets a specific network interface. In most cases, a wake-up pattern or a magic packet enables remote access to a computer that is in a power-saving state. However, some networking protocols use this packet for other purposes as well. So this is the explanation of Microsoft. It's kind of thing which enables your computer to awake from standby or sleep mode. So let's disable the magic packets. Click on the Windows icon. Here type Device Manager. Click on Open. Double click on Network Adapter, or you can click on this arrow and do a right click on an Ethernet adapter. I do not have that in here. If you cannot see the same in here, do a right click and click on Properties. In here, click on Advanced and search for Wake On Magic Packets. Once you'll have that, you have to click on this value and select Disable and OK. Method 5. Check the hardware drivers. You can verify whether your computer has a driver issue by running a software called DPC Latency Checker. DPC Latency Checker was created to interpret whether your system can properly manage real-time audio or video streaming by analyzing the latency of kernel mode device driver, including that the tool does not require an installation process. If you notice, red bar means dropouts because of high latency. That means something is off. You can either analyze to find the problem, or if the problem happens lately, then roll back the recent driver update of Windows 10. Method 6. Unplug the external hardware. Open the task manager by doing a right click on the task bar. Analyze the system interrupts. Unplug one device at a time from your computer and wait for a minute. Notice if the system interrupts CPU usage falls. If not, unplug the other device. If you find any external device causing the problem, then update the driver of that device and also search the device manufacturer driver. Method 7. Update BIOS. BIOS can perform badly and make your computer unusable, probably needing a new motherboard or replacing the computer. If you are not comfortable performing this step, then carry out your computer to any kind of computer store and they can check your hardware for you. So that's all for today, the methods to fix system interrupts high CPU usage in Windows 10. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.